agree to do it. So since the entrance evaluation, all the specialty or all the department have the way of evaluation before joining the program. So we actually combine them. So we agree to do it, and we put MEDEC as part of our assessment. It's not the only assessment, but as part of our assessment in the evaluation. So now MEDEC is compulsory for you to have before you join season. Dulu tak? Sebab bila MEM dah stay over, so now they impose university have to take MEDEC as part of whatever they want to do. So meaning that it's compulsory to use MEDEC, macam SPM lah. Kalau SPM dulu compulsory nak masuk university kena ada SPM ke apa kan. But now MEDEC is compulsory for you to join the program. So that's why all specialty, all departments have MEDEC. Even some specialty, for example, ONG and orthopedic, solely use MEDEC. They don't have their own. So we take the middle ground, which is in long term better if you want to select. So it's not centralized. So because when we centralize, we have no option and so everything tied. So we as a university is not independent. So that's why people, for example, from the hospital again, from other institution, can join. Once they use the centralized, they are tied. They don't have that option. That's why we university try to get away with it. But we think that it's not part of everything. So we still have to go through how to be one of them. That's the history. Right?
So that
ask us, and we are the one preparing the questions. So I tell you the level of the letter. I think we'll mention about the level. Then we are part of the vetting committee, and the level, the exam is consists of 60 true false multiple choice question. Betul lah, 60, right? 60, okay. There is negative marking. True or false ini biasa negative marking lah. But the whole, for example, the whole stamp, there is no minus lah. If you go minus 2 in that stamp, you get 0. So, dia tak akan carry forward lah. So, contohnya soalan 1, 5 kan? You kata jawab 5, you betul 1, salah 4. So, minus 3 contohnya. You get that minus 3, you get 0. So, dia tak akan carry forward lah. Dia habis kat situ.
So, one question maximum 5 marks.
Ah, maksimum 5 marks. Kalau you betul semua 5 marks lah. Minimum 0. Dia tak ada minimum 5 marks. Minus 0, 5. Tak ada. So,
minimum 0.
Oh, itu dia ada tak?
Ha?
Dari itu dia punya itu dia ada tak? Tak ada negeri mana
tinggal. Tapi rasa macam baca baru-baru ni pun
tak ada negeri mana.
Ada.
I thought about the request, but when I was there in the final say was from the contract. I was the chairman at that time. So they consult saya, saya kata, this is the condition. Okay. The duration of the exam is 2 hours. This is the component, apply surgical anatomy, apply physiology, apply general pathology, and principle of surgery. You must buat ni semua ada guna ni kan? The level, okay, principle of surgery semua lah, dari operative care, critical care, surgical technique, management, legal issue, all that. This is all the principle surgery, but it's not very big lah, so at the level of the pre-entrance. So, we design as such as very basic. Another thing is, just make sure you are in surgery lah, maknanya. Bukannya in plastic, bukannya in other specialty. That's why we have this. And the knowledge, the level of ni, actually we expect you to know, to be frank with you, the level is at the level of final year sebenarnya, persoalan ni. Final year medical student. So it's not, kalau tanya sama dengan Pak Wan, ada question sama dengan Pak Wan, but slightly low, slightly easy. That is how we design. So most of the question is yang final year punya question. Medical student. So it's not that hard. So the result will be released in band. Okay. Band 1 is the lowest and band 6 is the highest. So if you got 100, maksudnya band 6 lah. If you got 0, maknanya band 1 lah. So I studied the result yang hari ini tu. Rasanya yang lulus tak ramai.
Yang band 4 ke atas
tak ramai.
Only band 4 and above will be considered for entrance to master in general surgery.
So in other word, band 4 ke atas kita akan ambil untuk sitting for the interview. Ada yang band 4 itu?
So tak lain pun saya lah. So only band 4 and above is considered for the entrance evaluation. So tengok sini surgery tahunnya exam is on the 12-14 April puasa. Closing date of the knee is 4th month dah tutup dah ni pendaftaran. Fee is 800, mahal lah. But I think it's still cheap if you compare to the fellowship lah, FRCS or that. I'll show you later what does it mean. Okay. You look at this, the total of the application to SIP for Medex is 5,000. Surgery ni antara yang banyak tau. Nombor satu is family medicine lah. Family medicine 565. Okay. Anesthesiology nombor 2 right? Nombor 3 untuk midi eh? You can see much ni kan? Surgery ni okay lah among the top ni treatment still below to the emergency medicine. Internal medicine consider is a big, ini rendah. ONG mana tadi? ONG pun tak ramai eh? Biasa ONG lari stop. So surgery is very competitive
lah. Yes,
there is a number. Tapi you give me the number, less than half will pass. Can bend for example. That's our experience. So we go to the selection criteria for entrance into Master of Surgery program. This is universal for all the university.
and you are a doctor this. So you have a process medical degree, MD, MBBS, MBC, and ocular. Be registered to MMC. Have a temporary practicing certificate MMC. Bukan temporary kan? Sekarang dah pemerintahnya kan? Fulfill the criteria set by sponsoring body, for example Ministry of Health or University, yang itu kita tak campur. You can sponsor yourself if you like, tapi basically they sponsor us because it will fee. You will ask to sit for the English proficiency. I think the university discussed on this, and we actually think, still going with MUAT lah. Men berapa dia nak university? 4? Tak duduk lagi. You have to sit before you actually qualify yourself to sit to enter the master program. Kena ada English proficiency. Saya pernah dulu arts. Pernah ada arts? Ada di sini? Yes. You can use that
one?
Boleh lah. Berapa?
6.5.
6.5 bagus. You can use that one?
Ayah tu pun dia ada apa? Dia punya duration
period. Maksudnya
tapi macam cara duration period tu ada yang sepanjang. You can show us, you can show the university. Kadang-kadang dia terima. Kan ada duration tak? Ada kan? Buat AS tu. Saya AS tu saya pernah sekarang pergi UK tu, 7. Itu minimum kan? Nampaknya pun tak boleh pergi. Tapi Malaysia masih okey. Harus actually untuk open university pun very low kan, 5 atau
sekalian.
Untuk open university. But you are able to accept MUAT. But if you have others, to be okay. This is the one. Completed the medical specialist program as they mentioned, MEDEX. Ya kita tak ni lah. We'll have entrance after that. Entrance evaluation. The next thing is under go for the entrance evaluation, the component of which are determined by specialty board. In this case, is the board of general surgery. So, another question about MEDEX. That's all MEDEX. The next is the crucial part lah, is the entrance evaluation or interview. This is entrance evaluation into general surgery. Is organized by the Joint Board of Surgery, most of the time conducted in UGM. It is face to face, but last year for the first time we did the online interview. This year we don't know yet, and involve all member of the Joint Board. And most of the time you will have this 5 months before the intake. So this year the intake will be in December, 1st of December 2022. So minus 5 months, soon lah after raya we will have this. Okay. What will be the component? Component ni banyak lah. Okay. The component. Number one, you have to have the MEDEX exam. And we take the marks. Bedrock atas dia. Okay, we take the marks of that exam. And it will contribute about 20% of the overall component of the interview. So MEDEX kalau super banyak, kalau dapat 100%, dapatlah 20 markah. Okay? The range, bukan the question, the range. So it's about 20% lah. Okay? Kalau dapat 50, dapatlah 10. So I already told you that separuh dia yang lulus sebenarnya kan. And you feel okay lah. You got 15, you already have 5 marks extra to the others. 5 marks is very important. I tell you, bila masuk semua komponen dan cerita-cerita, the difference between, usually we take top 60. Top 60, lepas 61 dan sampai 65 tu is reserved lah untuk masuk. The difference is 0.2, 0.1, 0.3. So kalau you dapat MEDEX 15%, untungnya banyak lah. You can imagine. So what happened to MEDEX?
itu merupakan bonus yang didapat sebelum datang interview. Okay. So the next thing is ada examination. If you have MRCS, for example, MRCS dulu banyak. The previous this one is implemented in 2021 last year lah punya intake, and we designed it. Kita we encourage medek. MRCS kita downgrade sedikit. Masa dulu MRCS 15% banyak. So sampai dapat MRCS terus akan masuk jadi dulu lah. So we design that we put emphasis more in medek. So itu sebab MRCS part 1 A musuh no marks. B kalau ada A and B with the certified group of B, you get 5 marks. You dapat 5 marks lah. Okay. Mahal kan MRCS? Berapa?
Berapa?
3,000. Ha? 3,000. 40,000? 3,000. 3,000. So, medek tambah rambut. So, kalau you score medek 20, ada MRCS, dapat 20. Orang yang buang MRCS, dia buang medek. Medek dapat 10, MRCS dapat lulus. ALB tau. Dia buang ALB. Pawan tak kira. Dia dapat 15. Saya bukan nak ambil medek, tapi we have to emphasis on our program lah, on our sistem MRCS ni daripada polis luar kan. Saya daripada polis luar juga, tapi saya sokong program Malaysia kan. Nasionalis lah. Okay, that's how it is. So number 3, kamu ada component is publication and research paper maximum is 50%. This is the one that majority of the people like. There was one candidate come to me. Kebetulan bapak dia kawan saya mentor. Anak menantu dia apply for surgery. Oh, you can show me lah, saya tak boleh tolong sebab benda ni memang terang dan nyata, dia kata. Saya tak boleh adjust. Just show me apa yang you kurang. Dia punya publication dia pun macam mana you nak dapat. Hari tu dia dah kosong dah. Ha. So ada kat sini semua ada. I go through one two. International Oral Index Journal 5 marks per paper. So you kalau 3 paper dapat 15 lah. Index Journal lah. International Oral Presentation 4 marks. National Journal or National Oral Presentation 3 marks per paper. Poster apa semua tu, hospital level, hospital level 2 marks per paper. So International Index Journal ni payah lah ya. So you can work on this lah. Poster, abstract, oral presentation, hospital, hospital level, at least dapat 2 marks. So you dapat 10 dah tu. Banyak. Okay. And then if you are part of the investigator, okay, untuk research, if you are principal investigator, 5 marks. For your clinical investigation, you are part of the team, you dapat 4 marks. Produce lah, then 5. So maximum 15 marks. Number 4, surgery related courses and conference, maximum 10 marks. We review this one, previously this one has a lot. We reduce it to 10. So semua ni adalah, for example, ATLS, MTLL, Scripps, DSTC, 4 marks, maximum 8. Basic laparoscopy workshop, notes, BSS, this is 2 marks each. BSS 1 marks. Other relevant clinical courses 1 marks. Relevant surgical conference 1 marks. Maximum 2. So yang major courses ni lah, kalau you dapat, you will get. So maximum 10 marks here. So the number 5 will be work experience. This is free lah. You don't have to do anything. If you work in general surgery more than 2 years, you got 5 marks. Okay.
Under surgical specialty, less than 1 year, 0. 1 to 2 years, 1. Over 2 years, 2. General surgery, less than 6 months, to 1 year, 1 month. 1 to 2 years, 3 months. More than 2 years, 5 months. So maximum untuk working experience sahaja, 5 sahaja. But the rest is logbook. So you have to show your logbook. So kalau logbook you cantik, you dapat 10. Itu termasuk privileging or certain products, so it's important. For example, all these privileges lah yang senang-senang. Because I think one of the reason why we want these people to come to general surgery, they already have some experience of operation. Maknanya you can be independent during appendicectomy. Paling kurang lah dari the minimum. That's why we want this. That's the idea. Okay? So yang tu semua actually logbook is 10 marks. So termasuk yang ni lah privileging. Privileging ni kan kita buat privileging di hospital kan. Nah, kita dapat yang tu dapatlah 1 marks. Ada prosedur 0.5 marks. So maximum 10 marks. This is a lot. So you have to finish your logbook. So overall 1 to 5 is 65%. So before you come to the interview, this is what you have to prepare, or you have to prepare all this. You submit it to the Eurosteer or the committee kan, yang organize the organizer, which most of the time UPM. You collected all this and they will assess. You kena clearly mention, because otherwise dia terus terpapakan. Kalau you clearly mention that, so before you come to interview, you already have 65 marks. Okay. You tengok tak yang plus jadi berapa orang tadi?
380.
Okey, 380. Dalam 300 tercampur last year, mungkin jadi 400 akan apply for surgery this year. Right? You ingat, saya lalai kan interview 400 orang. Dan so, most of the time, kalau kita nak ambil 60, maksimum kita akan panggil is 100 and usually more than half sikit je lah. Kalau 60 mungkin 120, tapi most of the time kita ambil lebih sikit, 130 to 140, itulah we are call. So that one ranking depend on what? Depend on that marks, this 5 components. Sebab itu when you submit the all this, you show very clearly what you want to submit, so that everything is identified. Because nanti last time they complain, that's one candidate, that hey, I have this but why not included in the box? Bila tengok balik memang dia ada tapi dia tak mention, tak clearly mention. So terlepas pandang. Because yang buat ni bukan computer, yang buat human, dia masuk ke pandang, dia masuk ke. So very clearly, especially on the paper on that, I make sure you identify, very clearly mention it, so that you get it back. So kalau 65, kita akan ambil the top 130 lah, 140 lah to call for the interview. So I think this the component kan, component 1 to 5 is very important for you to gather and submit, make it very clear. Kalau you tak rasa tak sempat nak buat, ambil cuti 2 hari buat cantik-cantik benda ni, submit. But that is that determine whether you qualify to sit for the interview. So very important. Okay, you know the problem with the clinical, like clinical ni kita sempat nak buat paperwork, tak sempat nak isi korang. Saya selalu nasihat emos saya untuk especially kalau mau tak sempat isi korang, mau ambil cuti 1 hari ke 2 hari, jangan duduk kat rumah, duduk kat office, siapkan untuk isi korang. Hello. Selamat malam.
Education.
Hah?
Kode.
Kau. Kau. Kau.
No.
Hah?
Minum tu.
Minyak apa?
Minum kacang terus.
Masih apa? Ya, dua makan.
Ah, tak ada lagi kan?
Yang biasa benda ni lah, yang apa macam
siapa buat
macam benda
yang poster
holidays, right? Okay. The next is the interview itself. So now is very organized format interview. It will be held either online or face to face. All the interviewer. Yes, you have a question? Siapa? Terusdi. Ada soalan untuk Terusdi? Interviewer are from the institution involved. After the interview, we will finalize the list according to the ranking of the goals that you have set and specified in that interview. How important the interview? I say is very important. Sebab yang tu ranking tu kan, yang 65 tu, tu different sikit dia. Dari 1 sampai 140 tu, overall tu be different dalam 10 ya. Very close. I'm telling you, very close. So semua-semua tu 100, nombor 1 sampai 140 katalah yang bagi 140. The difference is probably 10 maximum. So very close lah. So boleh tengok tak? Boleh nampak tak? Tak apa besar kan? The interview is very important because you carry about 35 marks. So you kalau dapat 30 banyak lah. You can actually get it because you can actually, kalau dia tadi yang 1 sampai 5 tu dia nombor 1. Kalau dalam interview dia kalah sebab mereka interview. So interview is very important. So what will be the component of the interview? Component is, number 1 is candidate presentation, the career motive marks. Candidate presentation. You are given about 3 minutes to present. To present yourself, to present macam jual lupa lah. Kalau yang pandai jual lupa, laku lah kan. Yang kena ni macam tu. Yang pandai jual lupa, laku. So macam mana nak lakukan yourself, up you. But I'm telling you, from my experience, the presentation perlu. PowerPoint presentation tu kita baru markah tau. Nombor satu, nombor satu dia punya PowerPoint presentation tu. PowerPoint presentation tu terus kan, tak cantik sangat tapi cantik lah juga dia kan. Dia orang presenter lagi dulu. Cara apa? Saya kata saya yang baca detail pun payo. So take your time to do your slide. Sebab rasanya you are long about 3 minit ya. So maximum think about 5 slide dia saya rasa. So make sure you do your slide very nicely. Kalau you kena bayar professional pun, kalau you rasa you tak boleh buat PowerPoint, pay the professional. Tak rugi. I'm telling you. Because saya rasa maknya budak ni, aku yang buta IT pun pandai lagi daripada ni. Ini nak menjual apa ni? Ini nak jual lupa ya. You must be impressive. Nampak cantik. Ada satu candidate ya, dia ada pada Pening itu saya ingat, perempuan. Saya bukannya tempat gender je, tapi dia punya presenter tengok. Wow. Lepas pandai cakap pula, confirm interview dapat banyak punya 4 presentation. Confirm dapat 10. Kan? So, make sure you do your PowerPoint very nicely. Sebab I think ada 5 slide. Ya, 5 slide. Because you allow for 3 minutes to present. So, what are the component? You have to do introduction. Introduce yourself. Satu awal dan kahwin ke belum. Apa lagi? Ada anak ke belum? Ataupun dulu belajar ke mana? Kenapa you nak buat sendiri? Introduce yourself. Jual. Sell. Jangan lupa kita confident. Walaupun tak confident, masih tu buat confident lah. Faham tak? So, the component will be the introduction. And then, show your research presentation. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 je. 5 je. Search and research and publication. Yang tu satu slide. Betul-betul apa yang you buat, make it clear so saya boleh tick master ni. Courses on conference, kalau jadi komiti ke apa, tulis kat situ. Kalau jadi pengerusi, lagilah dia kata itu besar-besar. Kalau dia nampak saya pengerusi ya. That's how you sell yourself eh? Surgical experience, iaitu apa lah present, you dah buat apa, highlight what is your
specialty lah. Oh, you tell dalam speaker experience. Okay. And some reflection and aspiration. Kenapa you nak jual sejeli? Ya? Apa yang you bagusan nak jual sejeli? What you can contribute to us? Dapat tu kan? Oh, dapat 10 markah. You got 10%. 10 marks already. Okay? Buat jati-jati. The second part is scenario. Okay? Scenario ni is we give you a scenario. That's why now the interview kita yang design ni. The interview is more focused and more objective. Kita akan bagi scenario. Example, patient with appendicitis is because we want to make sure you are coming from surgery before or from somewhere else. So come with the need. What do you think is the diagnosis and what will be the management? Kita tak tanya you macam mana you buat operation laparotomi, kita tak tanya. More bad because we know your level. So based on that principle only, because we want to know, we want to make sure that you are from surgery. Itu je. That scenario is simple. InsyaAllah you boleh jawab. Kalau you pernah dalam duduk tiada sejeri lah, kode ni memang simple. Supposed to be very simple lah. Kita akan bagi scenario. So that one, the clinical basis of that will be about 5 marks. Tapi based on the scenario, kita akan melarut di sini. Ayah ni tengok maturity lah how you tackle the problem. We will assess your presentation tadi dah ada di clinical judgment and decision making. Yang tu kita akan tanya macam mana the judgment of the scenario and decision making lah. Kita akan make it tak straightforward, tapi we don't expect clinical experience, but we expect how do you tackle, how do you think, how do you think it. Okay. Interpersonal and communication skill, macam mana you deal dengan staff, macam mana you deal dengan relative. Kita akan jadikan scenario supaya you will deal with the staff and relative. Benda-benda macam tu, we will have that in that interview. And then teamwork, reflective of practice, maknanya contoh kalau you dah keluar, kemudian dia ada masalah. Nanti tengok you fikir you rasa you bersalah ataupun you rasa you betul sokong ke apa ke. Macam tu lah dari sendiri practice-practice. Macam audit lah, audit sendiri. Itu tengok you punya ni lah, you punya self reflection. So dia tu semua kena ada. That is what you want the candidate to come. Bukannya candidate yang datang aku saja betul. Ya, kita tak nak. Ya, aku saja betul. I am okay. Saya betul, orang lain tak betul lah. Itu yang kita nak. Kita nak supaya dia akan evaluate themselves again. Medical-legal issue kita akan letak juga. Medical-legal issue. Leadership, autonomy and responsibility kita akan evaluate juga dalam this scenario. Ethics and professionalism. So, ni banyak markah lah. So, I tell you, markah dia tadi 65 kan? Interview 35. Okay, 35. Banyak lah, 35. So, interview will be 35. I tell you, the last interview for me, the highest mark I get out of 35-30. Yang perempuan tu lah. Banyak lah interview. Dia boleh potong, kalau biasa dari 10, dia boleh potong lagi. So interview kan ada lot of marks. So you have to show yourself. Okay, I think that's all my slide. Okay, any question? Anything?